जय श्री कृष्ण टू ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे आई एम डिस्कसिंग हाउ टू मेक ड्राई पाउडर इंजेक्शन फॉर रिकॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ ए पुअरली वाटर सॉल्युबल ड्रग विद द हेल्प ऑफ मिक्स सॉल्वेंसी कॉन्सेप्ट। इन मिक्स सॉल्वेंसी कॉन्सेप्ट एज ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट सॉलिड सेल्स ऑल्सो हैव गॉट सॉल्युबलाइजिंग पावर, सो वी विल टेक एडवांटेज ऑफ सॉलिड एडिटिव्स विच आर यूज इन वेरियस इंजेक्शंस। So solubilizing power of these additives, solid additives, we will employ. I would like to show work of project, means research work of one of my M-Pharma student, Nilesh Maheshwari. So you please go through this research paper if you want to carry out the same type of research work, means I am telling from the point of view of the students. So please see this reference. Here Nilesh Maheshwari has employed Candace Horton Salicylatyl as water or as poorly water soluble drug, and it's a dry powder injection for reconstitution has been developed. He has Nilesh Maheshwari has made 24 blends, mixed solvent blends, using solid additives which are employed in injection. Of course, by name if we say that is sodium caprylate, beta cyclodextrin, sodium benzoate, sodium acetate and sodium citrate. Out of those 24 blends, I have I shall discuss about only 3 blends, A, B, C. The solubility of Candace Horton Salicylatyl in distilled water was found to be 0.002% weight by volume. 3 mixed blend, solvent blends are blend A, containing sodium caprylate 10 gram, sodium benzoate 5 gram, sodium citrate 5 grams, distilled water up to 100 ml. So this blend is A. You may say this sodium caprylate is 10% weight by volume, sodium benzoate is 5% weight by volume, sodium citrate is 5% weight by volume and all that. So in this blend, the solubility found that of Candace Horton Salicylatyl was found to be 1.90% weight by volume. So there is tremendous enhancement in solubility because of these solid solubilizers. B, sodium caprylate 10 gram, sodium benzoate 5 gram, sodium acetate 5 gram, distilled water up to 100 ml. In this blend, solubility found was 2.69% weight by volume. C blend, sodium caprylate 15 gram, sodium benzoate 2.5 gram, sodium citrate 2.5 gram. Sodium benzoate, sodium citrate 2.5 gram, distilled water up to 100 ml. Solubility in this blend was found to be 2.37%. So in all these three blends, there was quite enhancement in the solubility of the drug. Now I am giving example of blend A for students how to understand how to develop dry powder injection for reconstitution. So this is just for giving the example to facilitate the students for the development of this work. Now, composition of a typical dry powder injection for reconstitution of Candace Horton Salicylatyl, which is a model drug here in this project work, as per mixed solvent blend A. Formula for 1 ml intramuscular injection, model injection of course it is, Candace Horton Salicylatyl 8 mg, which is the dose, usual dose of Candace Horton Salicylatyl. Sodium caprylate 100 mg, it is a solubilizer. Sodium benzoate 50 mg solubilizer. Sodium citrate 50 mg solubilizer. Water for injection up to 1 ml. So you get a clear solution of drug. The solubility, now the calculation for the concentration of Candace Horton Salicylatyl in injection will be 8 mg per ml means 800 mg per 100 ml means 0.8 gram per 100 ml means 0.8% weight by volume. I am explaining to the students. So here 0.8% weight by volume is the concentration of Candace Horton Salicylatyl in this blend. Now the solubility in mixed solvent blend we obtained was 1.90% weight by volume, and here it is 0.8%, so it is easily dissolved by mixed solvent system. Solubility in distilled water was 0.002%, we have discussed like this. So in this way, these solid solubilizers were employed for making the dry injection for reconstitution. Okay, in this now, as far as the safety point of view or safety concern, means as per IIG means inactive ingredient guide note 1, sodium citrate, the limit of sodium citrate in IIG is 15% weight by volume. We have employed 5% weight by volume, which is safe. Number 2, sodium benzoate IIG limit is 10% weight by volume in injection. We are using 5% weight by volume, means it is also safe. One thing I would like to tell you, in injections, the sodium benzoate up to 10% and sodium citrate up to 15%, they are used as buffering agent. We are not employing them for buffering the solution. We are taking the advantage of solubilizing power of these solid solutes, solid additives. Number 3, sodium caprolate IIG limit is 1% weight by volume in injections, but here we have employed 10%. Why we have employed 10%? Thinking in this way that sodium caprolate is a nutritional agent. You see, the glycerides of free fatty acid, caprylic acid, they are found in different vegetable oils, etc., and we eat them. Means it is sodium caprylate is a nutritional agent, so it should be safe. So what will happen when injection in using 10% sodium caprylate will be used, then toxicological studies will be performed, and most probably we will find it to be safe. So a day will come when in IIG the limit will enhance, means from 1% to up to 10%, also definitely it will be there. Now coming to, for betterment of the understanding, please refer my RKM's lecture series 1, 12, 15 and 18 for more clarification. Now I would like to tell for the industry persons that they can employ this concept very nicely. They have got a large number of solid solubilizers which are employed for pharmaceutical formulations. Since all substances contain solubilizing power, so solids also have got solubilizing power. And of course, these industry persons, they will utilize small concentrations of several water soluble solid solubilizers to enhance the solubility of poorly water soluble drug for the development of dry powder injection for reconstitution of poorly water soluble drugs. Okay, of course, as far as their manufacture is concerned, means inject that of these dry powder injection, of course aseptic condition will be used, and whatever the drug as well as the additives, solid additives, will be free from pyrogen, free from microbes. All these conditions will be maintained, then only we can develop the injection. And of course the chemical stability studies will be done, toxicological studies will be done, and definitely I am sure that we can utilize this concept very nicely. And of course, by use of dry powder injection for reconstruction, a large number of injections can be developed, particularly of those drugs which are unstable in presence of water and all that. There are so many things to say, actually. Okay, now if you have any question, any doubt, please ask, and please share it to others. Jai Shri Krishna.